I warned you a long time ago, Elizabeth, not to name this ministry after a man or a woman, even before there was a ministry. I put it in your spirit, for none of this has been done by your hands. None of this has come forth from your mouth. It is from the mouth of Yahweh that has given birth. It is from the mouth of Yahushua, your Mashiach, that has been given birth. It is from the mouth of the Rekakadash Yirmiyah that has been given birth. If it had only been by your hands, it would have failed long ago. It is by the Shekinah glory's wind that blows across this earth, the holy wind of revival. It is not by your breath, or it would have failed.
2 Chronicles 36:16. But they mocked the messengers of Yah, and despised his words, and scoffed at his prophets, until the wrath of Yahweh rose against his people, until there was no remedy. Beware of touching Yah's true prophets and doing them harm.
Oh, how many times I've repented that I have made man. Yes, I know what is going to happen. That is because I am all knowing. I am omnipresent. I am omnipotent. That does not make it easier. Oh, how many times I have repented that I have made man. I look upon this world that is my footstool. I look into the hearts and the souls of every creature on earth. I look into the secret places of their hearts. I see the evil within. Even those that fill the churches. Even those that fill the temples. And I look upon their hearts. And oh, how many are so far from me. How many only have the knowledge of Yahshua HaMashiach. But their hearts are far from him. How many only know the story of the crucifixion, and how few have crucified their own flesh? How few have laid down their cross and followed after my son Yahshua? Again and again I send my apostles and prophets to warn. Oh, you hardened generation. You cover your ears. Your ears are full of wax. Your hearts are waxed cold. You cover your eyes. And then you dare cover your mouth. So you will not even warn anyone. Judgment has come. Away with your hypocritical prayers and praise. How few of you have bowed your knee to me to repent for this, for the sins, the sins of the countries you live in. I speak to the world, not just to America. From the farthest corners and the recesses of this earth. Sin is no respecter of a person. The sin is in all the nations.
nations, from the smallest countries, the provinces, cities and towns, some so small they don't even have names, and yet the sin remains the same. I am the one that hears the silent cries of my babies, those that never had a chance to breathe their first breath. You don't just kill them, you murderous, butcherers, you torture them. I shall put sinkholes under the abortion clinics. The fault lines are already there. It is invisible to the eye, but in my timing, it will be as if a giant hand reaches up from earth. And truly, as my servant has said, they shall be drawn down into the very bowels of hell, and the earth shall cover them over. And all the wicked shall be in them. You buildings that promote the evil lifestyle that you know that I abhor. You want to know what it is? Then read my scriptures. I shall do the same thing for you. The earthquake fault lines are already there. But think not, when this happens to a region, that any of the wicked will escape, for they shall go down, and it shall be I, the great God I am, that tramples them underground, but the righteous ones that stand forth in my name, the ones who are not ashamed of the name of Yahweh and Yahshua, the ones that honor my Sabbath days and keep them holy, the ones that know to love me is to obey me, the ones that love my scriptures and hide the word in their hearts, these are the ones that have built their homes on the solid rock, and they will not sink deep into the sand, for I am shaking this world in my rage, and in the days coming, you will see earthquakes, unprecedented, as any time before, for they will be shaken in a greater magnitude, as a parent has lost his temper, and shakes that child. This is how I will shake this earth, and say, wake up, wake up, wake up. How long? Must you try the patience of the Creator? Must you try the patience of the Redeemer? And I shall stamp my foot on the ground, and everything that can be shaken will be shaken. Everything can be uprooted will be uprooted. I shall shake up your politicians. I don't care in what country you're in. You're not no longer going to look to a government to provide. My children's going to know there is but one provider. And it's the same one. that poured water from a rock, that put manna on the ground. It is the same one that says, I will supply all of your needs according to my riches and glory. And I have no lack in glory. In my theory, I breathed upon not only the United States, but in various parts of the world. My hot breath, temperatures rose as my temper rose. Droughts came as my living water was refused. Did anyone listen? Did anyone wonder why? I stand by and I watch man's inhumanity to man. No, my children, you will not go through the great tribulation. Those that can trust me, but this does not mean that you will not taste the tribulation of man. Man's inhumanity to man, man that is power hungry and greedy, and evil to the core, that wants to wipe righteousness off the face of the earth, that wants to wipe my son Yahshua's name off the face of the earth. Since the beginning of time, there's been a war. And it is Satan that wars against all that is holy. His time's coming, but until that time, all flesh will be tried. You already have been tested. How many of you been in a fiery furnace? In many various ways. And before the cloud of witnesses, you still kept your love and faith. As the evil grow more evil, and the women breed with the demons. And his soulless ones come forth, full of an evil. You cannot even begin to comprehend, for they will have no consciousness, no concept of right or wrong, no love for anything or anyone. You call this a clone, but it is not a clone, for a clone would have to be a duplicate of me, and you cannot duplicate, for you are not a creator. It is Satan that is an imitator through these clones. You think when you eat cloned meat, you are nourishing your body. But how can that be when there was no life in that meat? You eat damnation to your own bodies. I prophesy to this handmaiden, that water would be rationed years ago, and now you see it to come to pass in places it's never been rationed before. Temperatures are soaring in countries it's never soared before. The earth is shaking in places it's never shook before. I'm angry, but not at those who can hear my voice. I am angry at those who refuse to hear. For hell was not created for a human, not even the lake of fire was created for a human. I sent a redeemer, my own son, to keep you out of these places. I gave my son, for I love you so much. I redeemed what the first Adam had done. And yet how many of you are hell-bent? How many are you afraid to witness to your families? How many of you live in houses unequally yoked? With a spouse that hates my very name. With a spouse that hates all that is holy. And yet they say, I am doing this for Yahweh and Yahshua's name. You do not honor me. In fact, you dishonor me. For Jacob I loved and Esau I hated. Oh, how I want to shout this. Should you not hate those that hate and despise all that is holy? Should you not hate those that blaspheme my Holy Spirit? What fellowship does Yahshua have with Belial? With Beelzebub? What fellowship can lightness have with darkness? Yet you insist on staying in these marriages that are not a marriage in my eyes. It is a bondage that I despise. For I never join them together. And yet you think you've done me a favor. And all you've done is grieve my soul. As the children are raised in heathen homes. And I've told you a house divided cannot stand. And the spouse cries out to me. Deliver me. Oh, if they only would have listened all along. If only they would have realized I divided long ago. So now, my children, get ready. Get ready. I remind you, you are your brother's keeper. For those of you who have cared, when you've seen your brother or sister go in lack, just remember that I have taken notes, and someone else will be raised up when you are in lack. For those of you that closed your eyes and ears to our brothers or sisters' cry, just remember this: your very cries one day and prayers I will despise. You have been tested. And I know those who have passed the test. Oh, but how I grieve, for those of you who claim they belong to me, when I tested your love and your compassion, and I have used this ministry time and time again, as well as others, to do so. And yet you were found wanting, greedy and selfish, only caring for your own needs. And now you will find out what happens when you pray. And heaven will not listen to you when you plead. Get ready, my children. But do not be afraid. Incline your ears, my children, to every word I say. Discern the spirit that speaks. For many false prophets have arose, and they assure you of false words. Of prosperity that will come to a nation, a country, or a state. That despises and thrown out. From the schools to the government, to the laws, all that I have proclaimed is holy. You will see this nation, this country, cities, the states, the providences, no matter where they are in the face of this world, come under the my judgment, come under my decrees. Vengeance is mine, I will repay. My baby's bride, chosen ones and elect, go and hide yourself in your houses, go and bolt your doors, for the time is coming, my children, when you will have to hide for a little while. You've already anointed your home. Stand and believe on Psalm 91. nakatenda, that you are sheltered under my wings, as the evil ones continue in humanity to man, as they continue to pass the laws that will make it hard for my children to stand. Hide yourselves, my children, under the shelter of my wings. It is your prayers, my children, my ear will hear. It is my hands, my children, that will wipe away your every tear. But for a little while, my children, just a little while longer, I know the names of every one that weep and wail and say, come, Yahshua, come. But don't do it out of fear, my children. Do it out of love. For I still am separating, and I still am dividing the sheep from the goats, worldwide. And the goats shall go to everlasting fire. And my sheep, I will continue to shepherd. Yes, my children, hold on tight. The helm of Yeshua's garment. And do not let go, as you stand in the fiery furnaces. Remember, I am with you always. Even unto the ends of the earth. Remember, my children, even those of you who will die, for my son's name's sake. They can only kill the body. They cannot kill the soul. And you will be with me in heaven, in your eternal home. And when you hear the words World War III, you will see the greatest level of iniquity. Pray for Israel. Do not forsake Israel. For I love Israel so much. I sent my son Yahshua there. His blood was poured into the ground. Do not give up on Israel. For I do have a remnant there. Hide yourself, my children. Yes, even hide yourself from the great God I am's wrath. For although I'm not angered at you, you're going to hear me shout. You're going to hear me stomp. You're going to see me shake. Well, even the very earth is going to be in fear and quake. You're going to see the flood of my tears. And you already have begun. For when the floods came, that was my tears. Oh, how many times I've repented that I made man. Yes, woman. But you forget that I know the beginning from the end, and everything shall be redeemed. Everything shall be restored. It shall once again go back to the time of Adam. And everything that was lost, I will redeem. It was finished at the cross. But do not think that a battle must not be waged. But don't do it in your name. You do it in the name of Yahshua. For the battle is the Lord's. And my children, remember this. You may lose some battles. You certainly have the wounds, but in my name, and in my son's name, Yahshua, your Messiah, you shall win this end time war.
We're not gonna run, we're not gonna hide. Yahushua's coming back for his bride. We're YDS, we're standing strong. This is our song. The enemy said in 3 days she'll die, but Elisheva Eliyahu's alive. She's a YDS, still standing strong. This is her song. May 24, 2005, Archangel Michael fought to get to her side, fighting off the enemy. He protects the bride, his wing hanging over her bedside. Like an innocent 2-year-old child, she touched his wing, marveling at the beautiful sight. The Judases will run and hide, reprobate enemies rejected, denied. Jeremiah 6:27-30 is your eternal life. No pride in Yahushua HaMashiach's bride. Wanna be like Enoch, raptured into the sky. He was pleasing to Abba Yahweh, he went to heaven alive. We're not gonna run, we're not gonna hide. Yahushua's coming back for his bride. We're YDS, we're standing strong. This is our song. The enemy said in 3 days she'll die, but Elisheva Eliyahu's alive. She's a YDS, still still standing strong. This is our song. We're not gonna run, we're not gonna hide. Yahushua's coming back for his bride. We're YDS, we're standing strong. This is our song.